don't work in absolutes. We work in, as though we're kind of living assemblage, where you've got like an online group, which is do stuff. You've got various platforms there. It's reviewing art and technology and activism. Then you've got a physical space like here, which is like a much more of a workshop lab.
You've got lots of different groups, completely changes
all the time. And then you've got the gallery space, which Art World kind of recognises because they recognise the word gallery or the word art. But actually, it's an infiltration into the kind of what's proper when we're kind of trying to expand what art is rather than close it down. We never do anything in space anyway unless it's connecting to the outside world. We don't believe in this kind of like gallery space that's enclosed with a kind of like scarcity object.
Yeah, they have a shared experience with something being in space. They can talk about it. You have a cup of tea in your hand, a glass of wine, or what. You know, it's
conviviality.
And different people will encounter it, and they have a different experience. They bring their kids, or you know, it's important.
And also.
And the locality is really important, and it gives us a way to understand what the work means to people when we see people responding to it with their whole bodies, not just by email.
I mean, I think it's important to say also is that 70% of people that come to our events and projects and shows are everyday people. They're not art going public.
Well, especially since we've been in the park.
Yeah.
And
that means we have to evaluate how we communicate what stuff we're showing.
And that's what we're aiming for.
One of the biggest problems, say, art culture, but also in political culture, is that the conversations are too abstract or too remote. Mm. And so there's no ownership. So by being physical, what we can do is allow people to take ownership on some of the conversations. They come back again. There's a legacy. There's all that stuff which people are having taken away from them. And it's about peer-to-peer culture, you know, you're kind of building it together rather than having yourself owned or your culture owned by someone else.